إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. من هذا اللقاء الطيب in this seminar in which we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a very beneficial for all of us. I would like to welcome all of you, and may Allah reward you greatly for the effort you have put forward towards attending this seminar. But just every one of us know what they had to go through to attend. So let us be serious and focus, inshallah ta'ala, and attend the classes with your heart and mind before your body. Because that's what's going to benefit and that's what's going to make the difference. Because we have to contemplate and reflect, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to share with you some jewels of guidance and some very important benefits from our noble Shaykh Al-Allama, Al-Walid Al-Doktor Salih bin Fawzan, Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahu Allah ta'ala, ومتعه بالصحة والعافية وغفر له ولوالديه وللمسلمين والمسلمات آمين. وهي محاضرة عن أهمية العلم الشرعي ألقاها فضيلته في إحدى الدورات العلمية. And this is a talk, the importance of knowledge and seeking knowledge of the legislation, the knowledge of the deen. And this محاضرة was given by our noble Shaykh Al-Allama Al-Doktor Salih Al-Fawzan Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala in one of the seminars was given in Saudi Arabia. It's not like seminar once every 4 months. They have seminars, subhanAllah, almost every week or every other week, and especially in vacations, like summer vacation, the school vacations and the like, you find many seminars going on in the same time, in the same city. And these seminars, by the way, who participate in them? Ulama. The ulama, the great scholars, and their students, who are known to the ulama, they're the ones that participate in these seminars. It will be beautiful if you have one of the ulama with us, like when we have Sheikh Hassan al-Banna a couple of years ago, if you remember here. That was a beautiful thing indeed, because he can learn from the Sheikh a lot in so many ways. Not just the knowledge he speaks of, but subhanAllah, the demeanors, the attitude, the character, the way he sits, and you should see the difference. SubhanAllah, it's amazing. But now, alhamdulillah, what we do, we bring the works of the ulama in our seminars. Even those scholars who come, alhamdulillah, they base their talks from the books and the talks of the ulama. And this is a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. Me and you, we could be just sitting here and just talking about politics right now. That's what happened in some seminars. The men get in here and spend half an hour joking around, instead of get straight to the point and give the people what the ulama says and connect the Muslims to their scholars. Because that's the khair. The khair, all khair and good, all good is in attaching yourself to the ulama, the great scholars of Islam. قال الشيخ حفظه الله والدورات العلمية لها أثر كبير ولله الحمد وهذا خير كثير لمن وفقه الله لحضوره واغتنامه والاستفادة منه. هو قال الشيخ الدورات العلمية لها أثر كبير ولله الحمد في سائر مناطق المملكة، لأنها يتولاها نخبة من أهل العلم يلقون فيها أنواع من العلوم الشرعية. The Shaykh حفظه تعالى, he says these seminars, they have a great impact. الحمد لله. Like I just mentioned to you earlier, in Saudi Arabia, they have them everywhere, alhamdulillah. And those who are in charge of these seminars and teach and give lectures and classes, they are the ulama, the scholars. وهذا خير كثير لمن وفقه الله لحضوره. He said, this is a great deal of good for those that Allah gave him tawfiq to attend the like of these seminars. واغتنامه والاستفادة منه. But only for those who they take advantage of that and they've been here, they know, they don't forget the purpose why they got here. And they have notebook, they have a tape, they have a recording advice, and they are here with their minds and with their hearts, along with their bodies. And they take notes and they review after that with their brothers. They sit in the corner for a half an hour, 10 minutes, 20. They discuss, what did you get? I'm missing this. Like earlier, alhamdulillah, a couple brothers approached me, jazakumullah khairan, and they says, would you please mention this, that the Sheikh Abdul al-Bukhari mentioned this and that. Alhamdulillah, this is how we benefit from the knowledge. قال الشيخ فإن العلم هو الحياة. He says that what brings your life and give a meaning to your life is knowledge. Is knowledge of the deen of Allah. قال والله عز وجل خلق الإنسان لعبادته وأمره بتوحيده وطاعته. As you know, the Shaykh he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the mankind for his worship. That's the purpose behind our creation, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has ordered us to worship him by tawheed and by obeying him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Islamic monotheism, through tawheed. وَلَا يَتَحَقَّقُ الْعَمَلُ الَّذِي يُرْضِي اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَيُنْجِي الْعَبْدَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا بِتَعَلُّمِ الْعِلْمِ النَّافِعِ لأن العمل بدون علم ضلال. Then the Shaykh, he want to say, there is no way for any one of us to perform an act that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no way for anyone to perform those actions that are pleasing to Allah and therefore save his servant in this life and in the hereafter, except through seeking beneficial knowledge. Except through seeking beneficial knowledge. Alayka as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. He says, because actions without knowledge is misguidance, is dalal, to act without knowledge. قال ولهذا هلكت النصارى ومن شابههم ممن يعملون بغير علم فسماهم الله سبحانه وتعالى بالضالين. He says, for this reason, the Christians, they were destroyed. They are destroyed. They are upon destruction. And everyone who imitate and emulate their example and follow their footsteps from those who act without knowledge. A lot of actions, they are not founded nor based on knowledge. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them in the Quran Ad-Dallin, those who are astray and misguided. لماذا؟ هل هذا له علاقة بجنسيتهم ولا بشرتهم ولا لونهم؟ لا. لأنهم يعبدون الله على جهل وضلال. They are misguided and astray. Has nothing to do with their color, with their country they come from. Has to do with one thing. They worship Allah. They claim they worship Allah, but upon ignorance and upon misguidance. ثم ضرب الشيخ مثال واقعي قال كالذي يسير في الطريق وهو لا يعرف الطريق هل هذا سيصل؟ He says like someone who's on a journey, get on a path, on a road, but he has no clue where he's going. No direction whatsoever. Like in our times, if someone, for example, someone were coming from New York, New Jersey, Minnesota, Texas, Ohio, Virginia, whatever the case it may be, sorry if I don't mention your state. All right, alhamdulillah, maybe next time. So if someone wants to come here, for instance, well, we all know what to do. If you've never been here, now you get GPS, or you got your smartphone. Maybe people still download something, I don't know, and print. I didn't see that much, but you have these devices. Can you imagine someone just get on the road, I'm going down south. Where he going? He don't even know where he going. No direction whatsoever. The Sheikh said, exactly those who worship Allah without knowledge. It's like someone who get on the path and he's driving. He don't even know where he's going. فَإِنَّهُ يَهْلِكْ بِغَيْرِ شَكْ. He said, this one, he will be destroyed, no doubt, and lost. قال فَكَذَلِكَ الَّذِي يَعْمَلْ وَيَعْبُدِ اللَّهِ وَيَجْتَهِدْ لَكِنَّهُ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ فَهَذَا يَسِرُ عَلَى غَيْرِ طَرِيق وَعَلَى غَيْرِ صِرَاطِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Says likewise, the same example for the one who worship Allah not based on knowledge. He didn't learn first. Naam, this person, he's diligent, performed a lot of acts of worship, a lot of efforts, but no knowledge. He says, this person, he's going on a path, but not the path of Allah. One thing is sure, it's not the path of Allah. It's not the path that is straight that Allah has chosen for His servants. ولهذا قال الشيخ في يحضرني الآن شيء. قال الشيخ حفظه الله: فالعلم النافع، العلم الشرعي، هو الذي يضعك على الطريق. لا شيء آخر، لا مالك ولا نسبك ولا جاهك ولا كثرة أتباعك. الذي يضعك على الطريق يا عبد الله هو العلم النافع المستمد من أصوله ومن مصادره الموثوقة كتاب الله وصحيح سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على الفهم الصحيح، فهم السلف الصالح. اكتبوا هذه الفائدة، قيدوها، فهي فائدة عظيمة. قال: العلم النافع هو الذي يضعك على الطريق، طريق الله، والعمل الصالح يبقيك عليها. العمل الصالح هو الذي يبقيك على هذا الطريق. I want to share with you a benefit that is not in this lecture, but however it is from the same work of our noble Sheikh, Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, Hafizahullah ta'ala. He says, only beneficial knowledge that is taken from its proper sources, the Book of Allah, the sound Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the right and sound understanding, that of Salaf al-Salih, the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim in the first place, and those who followed them upon good from at-tabi'in and atba' at-tabi'in, and the great A'imma of Al-Huda, as our noble Sheikh, Sheikh Abdullah Al-Bukhari, Hafizahullah ta'ala, mentioned today in his talk on the phone. Only that beneficial knowledge puts you on the path of Allah. Not your money. Not your color. Not your citizenship. And not your how many followers you have. Most definitely not your eloquency. Only this beneficial knowledge puts you on the path. And your actions, no, actually, your righteous actions keep you on the path. قال الشيخ حفظه الله: كما أن من اقتصر على العلم بدون عمل فإن الله جل وعلا يغضب عليه لأنه قامت عليه الحجة فلم يعمل بها، كاليهود ومن سار على نهجهم من علماء الضلال. Likewise, he says, if someone learn and don't act upon it, yeah, he's learning, but he's not acting upon it, these people, they earn the anger of Allah as well. Allah is angry with them. They earn the wrath of Allah and the anger of Allah. Why? Because the proof has been established on such people through the knowledge that they acquire. And they don't act upon it. Knowledge comes to them, they don't act upon it. He says, likewise, this is not just for the Jews, because this is one of their characteristics, the Jews, because they have knowledge and don't act upon it. He said, anyone, actually, who follow them on the same methodology from the ulama of dalal, from those who have knowledge and yet they don't act upon it. Ulama al dalal, those who yet to the people they are scholars, but actually they are scholars of misguidance and falsehood. Wal iyadu billah. قال: واما اهل النجات، واما اهل النجات فهم أهل الصراط المستقيم. After the Shaykh mentioned the two groups that we shouldn't be from, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to make us from them, those الضالين والمغضوب عليهم, those who went astray because they act without knowledge, and those who earn the anger of Allah because they have knowledge and don't act upon it. Now the Shaykh is going to talk about, قال: أما أهل النجاتي فهم أهل الصراط المستقيم. Those who are saved from this, they are those who are upon the right path, the straight path. أهله هم الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. Who are them? They are going to be with who? Those people who hold on to knowledge. They are on a path because they have knowledge and act upon it. Because remember, knowledge brings them to the path. Actions, righteous actions, keep them on the path. They die on this case, they will be with those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon them a great bounty from among the prophets, the truthful, the martyrs, and the righteous. And how excellent is the companion to be in the company of such people, as Allah mentioned in Surah An-Nisa. قال ولهذا فرض الله علينا أن نقرأ سورة الفاتحة في كل ركعة من صلواتنا. Said, for this reason, to save yourself from being among the two other destroyed parties, and if you want to be upon the right path with al-firqa al-najiyah, the saved sect, you have to do this. You got to seek knowledge and act upon it. And a reminder we have in every salat, Allah has made it obligatory upon us to recite Surah al-Fatiha. And we recite al-Fatiha in every rak'ah, whether the obligatory prayers or supererogatory prayers. You recite al-Fatiha, and it's a great reminder in Surah al-Fatiha. You're constantly asking Allah to put you on the path, the right path. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. No crookedness. Not to the right, not to the left. You don't go to the right and be destroyed. Don't go to the left and be destroyed. Stay focused on the middle course. الطريق المعتدل. The right path. Who are these people who are going to be in this right path? قال الذين جمعوا بين العلم النافع والعمل الصالح. They are those, regardless who you are, rich or poor, slave or king, white or black, doesn't matter, Arab or non-Arab, combined between beneficial knowledge and righteous action, you find yourself, inshallah ta'ala, on that path. Ahlus sirat al-mustaqim. You will be with the people who are saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah put them on the path. لأنهم يعبدون الله على علم وعلى هدى. Because they worship Allah based on knowledge, on guidance. لهذا فهم على صراط المستقيم. That's why they are on a straight path. قال والجنة لا تدخل إلا بعمل. The Sheikh says, you gotta act to go to the Jannah. You gotta perform action in this life. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة النحل verse 32, ادخلوا الجنة بما كنتم تعملون. Enter al-Jannah because of what you used to do in this life. ثم قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الكهف إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا خالدين فيها لا يبغون عنها حولا. Verily those who believed, and the ulama, they says for to believe you have knowledge. How are you going to be of infirm belief on sound belief without knowledge? You got to have knowledge that lead you to that sound belief. And do righteous action. They don't just believe and that's it. No, they do actions, not any actions, righteous actions. What is the reward? Jannatul Firdaus. جَعَلِ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّكُمْ مِنْهُمْ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. That's their abode. They will abide in the Jannat al-Firdaus. They will not be removed from them. No one can remove them from Jannat al-Firdaus. قال فالذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات استحقوا بهذا العلم النافع بعد الإيمان بالله عز وجل. How they earn this great bounty from Allah, this great reward, Jannat al-Firdaus. And they will be in there forever, dwell forever. Why? Once again, through iman and through righteous actions. And of course, they are upon iman because they have beneficial knowledge. The Sheikh says, "فالعمل الذي يوصل إلى الجنة لا بد أن يكون مؤسسا على علم شرعي من كتاب الله وسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا على البدع والمحدثات وما عليه أكثر الناس." حتى ولو كان باطل لا. So therefore, the actions that lead to the Jannah, those actions that lead to the Jannah, has to be, is a must, that have to be founded upon beneficial knowledge. From the Book of Allah, and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, not upon innovations. Not upon, oh, my people are on this. Yes, you like your people's food. It's okay with us. You can speak your people's language and dialect. It's okay. But when you come to the deen of Allah, don't say, look, I'm sticking to my people's deen and aqidah and ibadah. No. You got to stick to the haq, to the truth. Because that's what's going to get us to the Jannah. Actions that are the fruits of beneficial knowledge that is taken from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم قال الشيخ حفظه الله ولا يقوم بهذا العلم ويعلمه للناس إلا العلماء المستقيمون على طاعة الله. He says this knowledge now because of its importance, because that's what lead make you do righteous deeds and lead you to the Jannah إن شاء الله برحمة الله وبفضل الله سبحانه وتعالى. As the ulama, they mentioned, I want to share with you something briefly, that yes, you enter al-Jannah. There is many ayahs that says, this is the Jannah for what you used to do. But then there is a hadith, مر معنا هذا الحديث والحمد لله في دروس أخرى, في دروس العقيدة, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, لن يدخل أحد الجنة بعمله. No one will enter al-Jannah because of his deeds. هل هناك تعارض بين الحديث والآيات؟ ليس هناك تعارض. Is there any contradiction between these ayats when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, enter al-Jannah because of your actions, because of what you used to do in this dunya? Is this ayats contradict the hadith when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, none of you will enter al-Jannah because of his deeds? ما الجواب؟ من يعرف الجواب؟ نعم. أحسنت. نعم يعني يقول أهل العلم ومنهم الشيخ صالح الفوزان والشيخ ربيع والشيخ بن باز وغيرهم يقول أن العمل الصالح لا يكون ثمنا أبدا للجنة, لا يكون ثمن, لأنه لا يكون ثمنا حتى لنعمة من نعم الله, فما بالك بالجنة. The علماء they says because your actions, your righteous actions, never look at them as being a prize for Jannah. Meaning, don't you ever say, since I did this, I'm praying, I'm tahajjud, mashallah, sunnah, fasting, Mondays, Thursdays, I'm a good person, I got to be in the Jannah. That's my price. No, it doesn't work like that. You do righteous deeds, but you gonna enter al-Jannah bi rahmatillah, by Allah's mercy. Now, I just want to share that with you, inshallah ta'ala. So the Shaykh says this knowledge, who teach it? Who disseminated it amongst the people? He says, the ulama. None should do this but the scholars. Al-mustaqimun ala ta'atillah. Who are these scholars? Those who are upright upon obedience to Allah. Not somebody who's want to do whatever he want to do and then he want to come and give a powerful talk. But his life is all in, he's a mess himself. No, he says, these ulama, they are upright upon obedience themselves. هم الذين يبينون للناس ويعلمونهم أمور دينهم ودنياهم. These are the people who teach this knowledge and make to the people the affairs of their religion and also the affairs of their livelihood as well. قال فالعلم لا يؤخذ عن الكتب والقراءة ولا يؤخذ عن الجهال والمتعالمين ولا يؤخذ عن علماء الضلال والبدعة إنما يؤخذ العلم عن العلماء الربانيين. He says, knowledge is not to be taken only from books. Just somebody read a couple of books, he become an alim right now. Or someone who's been taking knowledge and attending the classes of ignorant people, who, for whatever reason, they become the ulama, like in our times. Look in our times, subhanAllah, these technologies made so many people, ignorant people, to be the ulama. A person, an ignorant person, he's teaching, I don't know what he's teaching, but it's not the deen of Allah. It is not what the Prophet ﷺ left the companions upon, but he is the alim now to so many millions of Muslims. Why? Because they like he has many hits. Oh, he has many hits. Look, Twitter, he has so many thousands of people, hundreds of followers. Is this how we look at it? No, you're going to look at the ulama al-rabbaniyun. He said, they're the one that teach the deen. Knowledge is not taken also from those famous people who, yes, they have some knowledge, but they are not using it in a proper way. That's why they're ulama al-dalal, wal-bida', they are upon innovations, and they are upon falsehood, wal-iyadu billah. Rather, knowledge is to be sought and taken from the scholars who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة آل عمران verse 79 ولكن كونوا ربانيين بما كنتم تعلمون الكتاب وبما كنتم تدرسون. نعم, the علماء, they have qualities and characteristics. They teach the people the small things. ربانيون, they cultivate the Muslims. They give them the most important matters, and even those most important matters, they break it down for them according to their levels. You don't find the alim Rabbani, he looks at the audience. That's why Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, the da'i najih, a successful caller, he has to have certain qualities. And one of them, of course, knowledge is one of the main things, and ikhlas, sincerity, because he wants good for the people. He's not doing it for himself. He's good, mashallah. And he loves, he's going to go and check how many tweets, how many people to praise him. La. He's doing it for the sake of Allah, because this is what's bring good to the people. This is what's going to put the people on the path of Allah. And he does it for the sake of Allah. He said, and also, a successful caller, he has to know, عليه أن يعرف أحوال المخاطبين. He need to have a thorough study on the people he's dealing with. So he can give everyone according to their levels. Don't you see when you go to a doctor? When you go to a doctor, as soon as the doctor sees you, says, give him 50 milligrams. Go home. Next. Now, what usually happens when you go to the doctor? What usually happens? Do you see the doctor first? No, you don't see the doctor first. Doctor come later on. Who knows? 20 minutes later, 7 hours if you're in an emergency room. But who you see first? Forget about the money people. All right, those ask you if you have this or not. Now, nurse come. Huh? And he will come and inshallah ta'ala. Huh? And he will do what? Ask you questions and check your blood pressure, temperature, pulse. Check your eyes, your tongue, your ears, your weight, your height, your age, any history of this, history of that. And then you were told by the same nurse, the doctor will see you later on, right? But it takes a time. I asked that question, what happened? They like, no, they take this information, give it to the doctor. Then when the doctor come and talk to you, he have an idea who you are, what you went through, your age, your... if you have any problems, you have any other illnesses, are you on any medication? And then after a thorough examination, he may even need to send you for what? For a text, x-ray, blood work, this, that. He may even have to seek assistance from another person. All of this to give you what? The right prescription that will benefit you, bi-idhnillah. Likewise, you're calling the people, you have to know who they are, where they come from. Do they have any doubts? Did they grow up somewhere they have shubuhat? Someone who has no shubha, clean. It's like a clean trunk, an empty trunk. You open it, mashallah, you can put stuff, your groceries in there, right? But now you open a trunk and find junk in it. Are you going to put your groceries in there? With trash bags, been there for ages? No, you don't. You have to do somewhat. Some cleaning first. Likewise, the akhwan. It's very important. That's why the juhal, they don't know these things. They just go there and make a big mess. Oh, I went there and they don't want it, or let it be. How did you present it, brother? How did you bring it? Did you follow the manhaj of a salaf in dealing with the people, knowing who they are? What you talk about first? ليس كل ما يعلم يقال. Not everything you know, you just put it out there. That doctor, he knows so many medications. So many. He didn't just go and prescribe anything he knows. No, he wants to choose the right one that work with this person. And even how much, the dose, right or wrong. Some people get 10 milligrams, some people get 50, some get 5, some get 2.5. According to who they are, based on the facts. Now, قال فلا يؤخذ العلم إلا عن أهله. وهذا العلم يا عباد الله يقول لا يحصل بدون تعب وبدون طلب. لا بد من طلب العلم أينما وجد، ولا بد من التعب في تحصيله وهو في سبيل الله. He said this knowledge we're talking about is not going to happen without تعب. Some people, they just want to be students of knowledge. They still chillaxing on their coach and drinking all the soda, the coffee, and this. They want to make an effort. Akhi, the Sheikh, he says, knowledge, you have to go through some difficulties. You got to go through some hardship to seek knowledge. You're not going to sit back and knowledge is going to come to you. Tawheed, you're not going to buy it, man, over a counter. Not even a prescription. Some sheikh give you a prescription. Oh, now you got a prescription, tawheed. And you take it two times a day. In 2 weeks, now you're an alim in tawheed. Doesn't work like that. It does not work like that. You got to work for it. Put an effort. Naam, the ride's going to be bumpy. It's going to be difficult. It's not going to be always smooth. You're not going to understand. People are going to make fun of you. You're going to be confused. And many things, shaitan is not going to leave you alone. You're on your way to tawheed class, shaitan has many plans for you. The wife have a plan for you. The children have a plan for you. But what is your plan? Are you a man with a plan? But if you have no plan, that's why you fell into the other plans. But if you have a sound plan, you're like, no, match it. Whenever you have a plan come your way, match it to them. No, can't stand. It was mine. This is my plan. I gotta come to this class. I gotta learn. I gotta finish this chapter. Hey, Naam. Says, you're not gonna seek knowledge. You're not gonna have knowledge without seeking knowledge. Hey, Naam. It's a must that you have to put the effort. Be diligent. Seek knowledge whenever it is. The true knowledge, the people who are teaching the sound knowledge, find them. Be a part of that blessed effort. But keep in mind, لَا بُدَّ مِنَ التَّعَبْ فِي تَحْصِيلِهِ. Just make this a reality. You shouldn't be surprised. Just say to yourself, look, to seek knowledge, I got to encounter some difficulties. I got to give up. Certain things got to give up. I got to change my life around. You got to get up early. You're not going to sleep early. You're going to give up some relaxation, this vacation. Huh? You're going to see it in yourself, subhanAllah. That's why when we read sometimes some biographies of some of the noble salaf, that we say that we emulate their example, you will find some of them, they don't even have time to eat. Some of them, he says, they prefer not a flour. They don't eat flour, but there is some bread that is already crumbs, over the solid food. Why? They says because one of the ulama says to chew, he can read the 50 ayah. He just takes something, swallow it. Easy for him. But some of us, we want to be students of knowledge and big collar shot and famous, and then we go to some restaurant and spend 2-3 hours, just didn't even order yet. Some people even spend 2 hours just going there. And we get together and we just talk about, I don't know what, politics. Some talk about LeBron James. LeBron James don't even know who you are. He don't even know if you exist. And they're going to talk about this and talk about that. وَهَكَدَ يَضِيعُ الْوَقْتِ. And time goes away. Now you get together, you have some fun, but then say, listen, akhi, who has a book? Who can benefit us? That's how you do. Okay, read something. So you go to any meeting, to any gatherings, go prepared. Take with you كتاب الثلاثة أصول. Take with you كتاب التوحيد. Take with you تفسير السعدي. Take with you الجرومية شرح ابن عثيمين. Take with you some books in آداب and أخلاق. And one person read one chapter of this, one chapter if you do it all the time, mashallah. Hey, نعم. That's what's going to be right in your veins. And that's what's going to stay with you because that nice food is going to go down the drain. But what's going to stays and we're going to remember, inshallah, from that gathering with those good brothers, mashallah, we studied that Kitab al-Tawheed. Even the man, the brother's wife or daughter that prepared that food for you, she's going to be happy because the time and the effort she put in the kitchen was not for waste. When she see that her husband is around or her son is around good companions. Yes, they ate, they enjoyed the food, but they studied some chapters from Kitab al-Tawheed. Can you imagine how a good woman will feel when she cooks for some people who just spent 3 hours eating her food, like she spent the whole day cooking, and they come and talk about I don't know who? How she would feel? La ikhwan, seek knowledge. And it's not going to be easy, but it is for the sake of Allah, ya akhi. Because you're doing it. This hardship that you may encounter is for the sake of Allah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له طريقا إلى الجنة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, whoever follow a path seeking knowledge, Allah will make an easy path for him to the Jannah. Allahu Akbar. قال فالعلم النافع هو الطريق إلى الجنة. Beneficial knowledge, that's the path to the Jannah. That's the path to the Jannah through beneficial knowledge. وهذا العلم النافع إنما هو في كتاب الله وفي سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. But this beneficial knowledge, where do you find it? Only in the book of Allah and in the sound sunnah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولا يؤخذ إلا عن أهله المعروفين به الذين تلقوه عمن قبلهم وألقوه على من بعدهم وتوارثه المسلمون. كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم العلماء ورثة الأنبياء. And this knowledge, this beneficial knowledge that puts you on the path that leads to the Jannah, it is taken from its people. Who are they? The ulama, الراسخون, الربانيون, the great scholars of Islam. Those who are known, because themselves they sought that knowledge. That knowledge, they didn't just find it in a bag, and all of a sudden he's a knowledgeable. No money. Somebody might not even work for a dime, and he's a billionaire. Grandfather died, leave him a billionaire. Grandfather died, leave you all knowledge, and you became alim. Just because your grandfather was a alim, now all of a sudden, hey, I'm a alim now because my father is dead. Doesn't work like that. You gotta seek knowledge from its people. The ulama, who they learn it from their teachers, from their scholars, and they disseminate it to their students, inshallah, that from them will be scholars. And this, the ilm, the Muslim, they inherit the knowledge from one another. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, العلماء ورثة الأنبياء. The scholars of this deen, they are the inheritors of the prophets. قال فالعلم سبحان الله the Sheikh and I am skipping سبحان الله I'm not I look as you see I highlighted but these are a lot of things because we'll never finish these things inshallah ta'ala today but inshallah we may find another time to share with you if you don't finish we'll share with you inshallah another time we'll find some time inshallah because that's why we're here right are we here to eat that's a tricky question right yes you gotta eat but that's not the purpose right this is not like a food fair Is it? The flyer says a food fair from all different countries. It is. I'll come and taste your delicacy. This is knowledge. So this is the main part. Yes, we're going to eat, but eat a little bit. Don't make it your purpose here. Oh, you spend 6 hours looking for food. Walmart is right around the corner. Get you a yogurt, a salad, a date. I said, alhamdulillah, she should do it. But still, inshallah ta'ala, those who came from far, they are our guests. Okay? May Allah help us and aid us to be a good host. Ameen. قال فالعلم لا يشبع منه. Yeah, you can say, ah, oh, it's enough, أخي. That food is enough. Oh, this is enough. Oh, but knowledge, no. He says, a person really who knows the importance of knowledge and the value of knowledge, he will never say it's enough. You can never be satisfied from knowledge. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, as the ulama, they mentioned, the Shaykh says, Allah did not command the Prophet ﷺ to ask him so that he can increase him in anything than in knowledge. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Taha, وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. And say, my Lord, increase me in knowledge. وَلَمْ يَأْمُرْهُ بِزِيَادَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا مِنَ الْعِلْمِ. Allah did not order the Prophet ﷺ to invoke him so that he increase him in anything except in knowledge. So we should look at seeking knowledge in a different way. And this is vital. This is something that we cannot, it's not an optional. Whether I learn or not, it's not an option. It's not an option, يا أخي. قال وكل الناس بحاجة إلى العلم وكل المسلمين كذلك أكثر من حاجتهم إلى الطعام والشراب والهواء. It says all of the people that are in dire need to seek knowledge and to acquire knowledge of the deen. All the Muslims. You're a Muslim, you have to learn your deen. Don't be a Muslim by affiliation. Just because you're a Muslim, you're born in some Muslim country, that make you a good Muslim. No, you got to learn. You got to learn. He says, why? Because the Muslim, they're in dire need of knowledge, more than they need food, drink, and air. The fresh air you breathe. Can we do without food and drinks? We're human beings. And air? So why we do without knowledge? And knowledge is more important. لماذا قال لأن العلم تحيا به القلوب وتستنير به البصائر ويدلك على الله وعلى جنته فهو ألزم من الطعام والشراب والهواء لأن هذه كلها مغذية للأبدان وأما العلم فهو مغذي للقلب والبصيرة. He says knowledge bring life to your hearts. Aina. That's what knowledge do. Revive your hearts. Bring life to your hearts. Give you insight. You see clear the path of good from the path of evil. The halal is so clear from the haram. Nobody gonna bring no ambiguity in front of you. On 10 years later, you already establish a big business on haram. Now you're so clear through knowledge. Why people later on they come, oh, the riba, oh, halal, oh, is this marriage is okay, is this transaction is okay. Why? Because they were doing actions without knowledge. He says, knowledge revive your hearts. Knowledge lead you to Allah. This is how you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through knowledge. Knowledge lead you to the Jannah. You want to be in the Jannah? There's no other way except through knowledge. So he said, it is more vital and more important than food, drink, and air that you breathe. Why? Because food, drink, air, that's only they will bring you benefit and good to what? To your body. While knowledge is good for your hearts. As one of the Salaf says, اعتني بنفسك وأكرم وأتمم مكارمها فأنت بالنفس لا بالجسم إنسان. One of the Salaf make a line of poetry. He says, take good care of your soul. Complete its good manners. Because you are a human being through your soul, not just through your body. That's why you're a human being. أي نعم. نعم. قال الشيخ فالإنسان وإن أكل وشرب من أنواع الفواكه والأشربة والأطعمة فإنما ينمي جسمه فقط. He said that because the human being when he eats, he or she, and drinks water and the like, eats fruits, varieties of food, that benefits only his body. It benefits his body only. وَأَمَّا إِذَا تَعَلَّمَ الْعِلْمَ النَّافِعِ وَعَمِلَ بِهِ فَإِنَّمَا يُغَذِّي قَلْبَهِ. But when he seeks knowledge, beneficial knowledge, and acts upon it, now he's benefiting his heart. That's the nutrients of the heart. That's the food of the heart, beneficial knowledge. بِمَا يُؤَهِّلُهُ لِعِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. And this is how a person is qualified to worship Allah correctly. Not just by doing actions, no, by doing the right actions that are based on beneficial knowledge. فَلَا بُدَّ مِن تَعَلُّمِ الْعِلْمِ. The Shaykh says once again, it is a must for the Muslims to seek knowledge, to make effort and learn your religion. قَلْ مَا يُعْفَى أَحَدٌ مِن تَعَلُّمِ الْعِلْمِ. No one is exempt from seeking knowledge. عَلَى قَدْرِ مَا يَسَّرَهُ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Put forward efforts according to your ability. Nobody is saying give up your job and go somewhere and move, pack your stuff. لا. According to your abilities, but you still have to find time to read, to listen to the ulama, to attend the classes. If you are around the ulama, you'll be there, alhamdulillah, in their classes. In Saudi Arabia and other places that they have ulama al-Rabbaniyun, inshallah. But if you are not, then sit with those students of knowledge who they connect you with the ulama. You got to find some time for that. The same way you find time for other things. Now find time, say, look, this is why I'm a Muslim. I'm a servant of Allah. I got to be on the path of Allah. Nothing will put me on the path but knowledge. And nothing but keep me on this path by righteous actions. And my action, they will never be righteous without beneficial knowledge. See how it's connected? And you got to find time to learn the deen of Allah. So you're not exempt. لا يبقى الإنسان على جهله ويقول أنا جاهل ومعذور بالجهل. So no one should stay ignorant and then use that as a justification, as an excuse. I'm ignorant. Allah will forgive me and pardon me because of my ignorance. قال بل إنه غير معذور بالجهل ما دام عنده مجال لتعلم العلم ولو قليلا فإنك لست معذورا أمام الله سبحانه وتعالى. So rather this person, it is not exempt. He's not excused. Can I use this excuse, ignorance? As long as that person have the ability to learn even little bit of knowledge. You have the ability to learn, but you're negligent, so don't use this. Don't just say, oh man, I'm ignorant, man. I didn't know anything, because he didn't want to learn. Because I didn't want to put efforts to learn. So the Shaykh said, this person, it is not, cannot use this as a means of justification that he's ignorant. He said, if you have the means to learn, well, alhamdulillah, the means these days, the Shaykh, he talk about them, he said, from them, هذه الدورات. قال فهذه الدورات العلمية. والشيخ لا شك يتكلم عن دوراتهم. نحن دورتنا الحمد لله ما شاء الله. نسأل الله أن يجعل الله فيها الخير. نسأل الله أن يجعل فيها الخير. ليس هناك مقارنة أصلا. أين الثرى من الثريا. لكن نسأل الله أن يجعل فيها الخير. قال فهذه الدورات العلمية في الحقيقة مشاريع عظيمة ومفيدة. نوصي بحضورها أينما وجدت ومتابعتها مهما أمكن. فَإِنَّا هِيَ الْحَيَاةُ لِمَنْ وَفَّقَهُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Then the Shaykh says, these seminars, these educational seminars, in reality, they are the true beneficial investment in your life that you invest. And let me remind you, the Shaykh is talking about those seminars when he participates, and Shaykh Rabi, and Shaykh Ubaid, and Shaykh Luhaydan, and those seminars that the Ahlul Ilm, there is no comparison between those seminars and ours, even though we ask Allah to make this seminar a beneficial one for all of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put on our tongue that which brings benefit for ourselves and for our brothers and our sisters in Islam. The Shaykh says, we advise you to attend these seminars, of course, those. Okay? So I want no one to say, oh, Abu Muhammad using the Shaykh Fawzan seminar and says, come to this seminar. That's not what I'm saying. I'm telling you, the Shaykh is advising him, who's talking on those seminars. All right? But we can say too, Ya Akhi, you see, if it is a seminar of Ahlul Sunnah, people upon عقيدة صحيحة upon correct and sound creed, they adhere to the way of Salaf al-Salih, you attend. And you be with them, inshallah ta'ala. Because as you see, all of us, alhamdulillah, that we are talking, we're talking from the work of the ulama. If I start talking for myself, I'm just telling you right now, don't sit. Or if you choose to sit, don't listen to me. Or remind me, because I'm a human being. I may start forgetting and start telling you stories right now. May Allah protect my tongue from that. But it is an obligation upon all of you to remind him, say, brother, why you switch the channel? You were saying Sheikh Fawzan, now you say, I am saying, would you please back go to the channel number one? This is an obligation upon you, you remind me, because this is how we're going to grow. And as long as these seminars that are not attended by the ulama, but alhamdulillah, their work and their books and their talks are taught in them, there is khair in them, inshallah. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله صحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.